What's going on, guys? T-Mart here, and today we're going to be checking out something a little bit different, but I've got the feeling we're going to have a ton of fun. This, my friends, is Armored Warfare. So it's actually kind of funny. I remember seeing comments from a few of you guys on previous videos recommending this game to me. I think it came out around like the beginning of October or so, so I kind of already knew what it was. And then just recently, the guys over at Obsidian Entertainment, the developer for the game, actually reached out and were kind enough to sponsor this video. So I thought that was kind of cool. But yeah, this game looks sick, looks like a lot of fun. It's a free-to-play game, so if you want to play it, it's 100% free. You can just download it on your computer, which is nice. And you know, obviously, as you guys can see, it's all about like tank warfare. It's really cool. So they have like these big 15 versus 15 PvP battles, and then they also have player versus environment battles. So it's kind of like almost like a campaign story mode type deal, which is pretty cool. And they're like, they have like over 85 vehicles, which is absolutely nuts. They have like tanks like this one. They have like you know, like main battle tanks. They have light tanks. They have AFVs. They have tank destroyers. They have, you know, all kinds of different upgrades for each of these, both visual and in terms of like your, you know, ammo that you can use and the amount of armor that you have and all kinds of crazy stuff like that. I mean, really, it's one of those games. It's just like, it's super strategic and tactical. It's not a strictly casual game where you can just hop in and mess around and not really care. Like, there is a lot of thought that goes into this. Yeah, it's like you're fighting against tanks. There's awesome, you know, action and battles and stuff like that. And there's a fun part to it, but there's also a super strategic part to it that adds on top of that. And it's got like multiple layers. So it's kind of cool. You know, I feel like that makes the game a little bit more rewarding. And, you know, it's like, you know, they said it's like Grandmaster Chess versus Candy Crush, where, you know, like both can be fun to play, but one is definitely a lot more strategic and it takes kind of like a special type of person. So I like that. I like that where you kind of have to invest yourself into something and you get rewarded because of it. I think that's kind of a cool way to do a game. So I actually kind of skipped the tutorial when I first loaded up the game. Totally by accident. I definitely think I could have used it. I can't figure out how to bring it back up though, so we're gonna start things off a little bit lighter. So like I mentioned, we have PvP, which is player versus player, so it's like 15 versus 15 humans going against each other, or PvE, which is player versus environment, so it's like a group of humans versus like the AI. So we're gonna start with that, kind of learn the game a little bit, and then we'll move into PvP and see how we do towards the end of this video. But you guys can see we're in the garage right now, and there's just so much customization that goes into this. Like I mentioned, you can customize your tank, the way it looks, the armor on it, the, you know, kind of like weapons in it, stuff like that. You guys can see all of that right here. You can also customize your crew. So you guys can see you have a commander, he has different skills you can upgrade and unlock and stuff like that. Your crew with the same thing, you can change out your crew and, you know, get different people for different, you know, tanks, which is like amazing. And then on top of that, you can also customize your base, which is like this giant thing that we're in right now. Like, this is our base, and you can like make it better and bigger and stronger and stuff like that. Like, it's just, it is crazy how much customization goes into this. It's way too much for us to handle in one video, but it's just like, it's out there, man. But and so I wanted to check out, it looks like we start off with 6 tanks. I just created a new account. Like, this is what everybody starts off with. We don't have anything special. So it looks like we have the M113 here, which is kind of like a, man, that thing's kind of weird. Let's see the details on that. It's an armored fighting vehicle. Alpha damage is not that great. Sustained damage is fantastic. Defense, it's a little bit below average. Mobility is pretty far up there. Utility and targeting. We also have the PT-76 here. This one, ooh, the alpha damage is a little bit better. So this is a light tank. And sustained damage, a little bit lower. Defense is about the same. Mobility, utility, targeting. Next up, looks like we have another AFV here. The Lav 150. So this one, again, not really about doing damage. This one is quick. Look at that mobility. You can like flank around the enemies and stuff like that. That's kind of cool. Bonus overall base capture speed. That's pretty good. We have the M41 tank here. This is another light tank. Alpha damage is up. Then we have the Patton 48. Looks like this is going to give us a little bit more alpha damage, a little bit better defense, but we're slower and less less utility. And then finally we have the T-54. Oh man, look at that, dude. Look at that defense. It's got the highest defense, the highest alpha damage out of everything. This is the big boss hog tank. It's also got the lowest mobility, utility, and targeting isn't, I guess it's not bad. I kind of want to start with this one. I feel like that's like the basic tank to start with. You know what I mean? Like, we can like just be a big hog that rolls around and kills everything. So I think that's what we're going to go with. So we're going to select that thing. And because we're so new to the game, we don't really have any credits or anything, so I don't think we can do too much customization. Let's see our ammo here. So we have armor-piercing ammo, so this is good against like heavily armored objects. And then we have high-explosive anti-tank heat ammo, which is, it does more damage than the armor-piercing, but it doesn't pierce armor as well. So if you're shooting at a super armored thing, armor-piercing is better. If you're not, then this is better. So I feel like you can also add other ammos and stuff, but we don't have those unlocked. Can we unlock those? We have 1,000. I feel like, I think you have to rank up to get those two. You guys can see it's got like the red lock. So I feel like we're probably gonna be facing a bunch of tanks. So I'm gonna take this down to 17 and I'm gonna bring this up to 33. So go ahead and confirm that. Got that. And then we're gonna start up a PvE mission. We're starting the initiation. Oh, it's a tutorial, daily contracts. Should we do the tutorial? That'd be kind of cool, right? And then we could hop straight into PvP. Alrighty guys, here we go. Operation Quarterback Briefing. The People's Liberation Movement thought they could take the oil refinery in the Middle East, take it back, and hold until reinforcements arrive. Let's go, boys. Retake the oil refinery, destroy supply vehicles is a secondary objective. And then we're getting rewards for completing it, which is pretty cool. Alright. Let's go, boys. We got a whole squad here. So yeah, like, each different type of vehicle has, like, different, like, things that it does better. So everybody kind of plays their part, you know what I mean? Like, if you're in a squad, you're going to want some AFVs like the guy
Welcome
in front of me.
Welcome to the Desert Black Company. The
as well as some destructive guys like me.
The refinery, but you're going to help us take it back. We need to take the refinery. Otherwise, the PLM will control oil prices for the entire region. I don't recommend the front door. Good luck.
Don't recommend the front door. Good luck. You detected enemy aim, then mouse one
Looks
to
like
fire.
The PLM had a backup plan to escape with supplies. If you take them all out, I'll throw in a bonus.
I can do that. So the right stick enters into like sniper mode, or the right click.
Target's gone.
I'm gonna be able to get him. We get over this hump, so we're gonna be able to see him.
Identify.
Hostile, tank.
Gotta move, boys. This guy's weak. Alright, so we're heading this way with a couple of teammates. Looks like we got a couple of weak enemies. Shift enter sniper mode.
Direction.
Woo! Got this guy all the way down there. Are we gonna be able to, dude, we're gonna try to snipe him from all the way over here. Oh! That shoots way faster than I thought. I was trying to lead him way too far. Yes! Hit target.
Good work. That should slow them down for a while.
Looks like he's moving.
Identify target.
Hostile, tank.
Hide while reloading. Takes a while to reload. Hide behind some cover. At least keep him moving. Alright, that makes sense. This isn't too bad. I can do this. Oh yeah, switching to ammo. So now we can switch. We just switch to our high damage, low armor piercing ammo by pressing 2.
Identify.
Target locked on. Hostile, tank.
And it's perfect.
Good hit.
Come on, reload, hurry. Yes! Got him, boys, let's go.
Loader,
switch back to that armor piercing. Look at that guy. He's got like an automatic on his thing. That's pretty cool. Look how powerful it is. But yeah, dude, that's the cool. I mean, like, look how fast he's moving compared to me. He can move around quickly. And, like, look how fast he's going up the hills. He can, like, flank around the enemies and use that full auto gun to be able to take people out. See this guy yet?
All right, Black Company, you're in position. Hold for air support. Incoming hostiles.
Let's go!
Identify.
Hostile, attack,
direct hit.
Double down, baby. Shooting us, I can't tell. We have 795 HP left, dude. We are a brute. Let's go. Soupy 2. Oh, that's who we're getting shot from. This couldn't be any slower.
Loader, AP.
Reload.
Loader, AP.
That thing was like sweeping around like this, dude. It was insane. All right, let's get inside. We're taking back the refinery, baby. We're getting this oil money. Capturing the enemy base. Got about 10 seconds left. Is this the capture spot? Assuming this is the giant capture spot. Look how small that gets. We gotta be watching out for it. Where are they gonna be coming from? I don't know.
Well done. We've retaken the refinery. Enjoy your payday.
Yeah, boys! Look at this, they're coming in. Our squad. Good stuff. All right, that's pretty simple, I guess. So, I mean, I'll probably play some PvE on my own, because like I said, it's kind of like a story mode in a way. But I think for the most part, we got the controls down, and that's kind of all I was looking to do. So, we're going to hop into PvP, and we're going to see how we can do. Alrighty, guys, here we go. So,
affirmative.
Loader, ready up.
Basically, the mode we're playing is caps the enemy team's base, or, whoa! You just destroyed that fence, bro! Oh my gosh! We're in a tank, we might as well destroy stuff. Heck yeah. Anyway, the idea of this game mode is, capture the enemy team's base or kill all of them before they capture your base or kill all of you. It's pretty standard for tank warfare, and, we're gonna do it. So looking at our map, they should be up here and to the left. Go get up on this ridge, or should we charge? I think we're gonna be smart. We're gonna stick with our squad. It's nice if you right click, you can look around without moving your turret, so you can kind of like see things without it like moving all over the place. See that? They should be out there. Watch out, brothers. Guardrails, get out of my way. Oh, somebody just spotted somebody. See him currently. We're gonna keep on moving down the road. Just took a little damage. Part of me wants to get off the main road and YOLO it down this part. Here we go. Build up some speed, yeah, buddy. This guy's pretty weak. Look at that shot, baby.
Identify.
I'm gonna see another one. Get stuck on a rock right now. Oh gosh. Forget how stupidly big these things are.
Identify.
Hostile. Good hit.
Just got us two.
They hit us hard.
There's two of them. We want to get around this corner ASAP.
Hostile.
All right, let's get back with the squad. Gotta work. It's all about teamwork. I wish I knew people who were playing this right now. Like, I wish I could talk to him. You can talk, you can chat, but the squad's not really chatting yet, so.
Identify.
Hostile, tank.
Looks like our right track's a little bit weak. And we're spotted. You guys can see that thing means we're spotted. That yellow, like, eye above our middle part. Critical track damage. Let's go, boys. Look at me shooting through the bushes, getting all sneaky beaky like.
Took a hit. Tracked out.
Identify target.
Hostile, tank.
Tracks up.
So they temporarily took our track down for a minute there. We couldn't move. That was kind of scary. Teammate with a firefight over here. I kind of want to go help him out, but I'm scared about getting hit by those guys over on my left. Oh, my other teammates are getting them. I got you, homie. Rescue inbound.
Identify target.
Hostile, tank.
Yes. Got a hit. I don't know who I want to go after, you know what I mean? We still got somebody over there, or is he done? I think he might be done. Our team is rolling right now, boys! Let's go, we're spotted right now, where from? Oh. Hurry up.
Target hit.
Oh, there's two guys over here. It's a 2v2, it's okay. We got one of them pretty weak, I'm about half health. Also spotted right now. Oh, Jesus.
Identify target.
Hey.
This elevation changes the game. Just did some critical track damage. Is that critical track damage to me? I think that might be critical track damage to me. Roll out, boys. There's two guys left. They're both here. This is the final two of the enemy team. Oh, what? We fired way too early, dude. Oh, gosh. Using my teammate as cover. YOLO. He's dead. We just won. Shoot. You gotta wait for that green circle to get smaller, because if you don't wait, you, like, you're inaccurate. Like, the shot can go anywhere within that circle. So you gotta watch out for that. That's, man. Oh, that was awesome. All right, so we didn't do too bad for our first game. How did we do? I don't know in terms of, like, kills and deaths. Wanna check that out. So it looks like we had 4 assists. Unfortunately, we couldn't finish out any kills. We had 6 vehicles spotted and 857 damage dealt, which for a first game, I'll take that. We didn't die. We went ham. It was good stuff. So I'm going to say, let's kind of have some fun here. Let's check out some of the other stuff. I want to try this little guy. So this thing has 20mm armor piercing incendiary autocannon. Holy cow. All right. So we're going to go ahead and deploy PvP with this, and we're going to see what happens. Alrighty, guys, here we go. So round number 2, we're gonna be in this tiny little AFV, 600 armor piercing incendiary rounds. Driver, I honestly have no clue.
Gunner, scan for target.
Affirmative.
No clue what to expect. I just know we aren't gonna be able to do much damage. Look at how fast we can move and still be accurate. So we need to always be moving, always be firing, and getting behind the enemies. No, like, so you guys can see down in the bottom right, I'm gonna go to the far left, And then I'm gonna go straight up the far left, all the way to A0, and then I'm gonna cut back across right, and hopefully I'm gonna be able to get behind these guys to where they won't be able to see me. But who knows what'll happen. We're gonna try to get real saucy with this one, boys. We'll see see if it works out. Oh yeah. Shoot, I was expecting that to be a line you could cross, and then like what's it called? It'd say like, get back to the battlefield in 10 seconds or whatever. But it's not a line you can cross, it's a straight up wall, so we gotta watch out for that. All right. Run into some problems with our plan, as well as there's a tank over there, dude. I just feel like we're gonna be, melted. Can you go across this? Oh, you can't, okay. I feel like if we get spotted, we're dead, but as long as we don't get spotted, we're gonna be okay. This guy's got 1105 HP. We have 660, dude. He's looking for us.
Identified.
Hostile truck.
Do you see what little damage we're doing right now? We did like 20 damage right there. Oh shit. Yep. Critical module hit. We're down to 212 HP. I don't know how to play this tank. We need to get back at our big daddy, dude. Holy cow. Or maybe that might be a little bit better, because I think that one has a little bit more damage. It's still pretty fast though. Oh my goodness, dude. We tried to be sneaky, it just didn't work out. I'm gonna see you guys in the next game. So this is interesting. This one here actually does less damage. It's got less defense. And it's a little bit faster though. That's pretty crazy. We totally, dude, oh my gosh. That's a special type of vehicle that it takes to play. Like that, I mean, it's fun, obviously. And if it would have been a 1v1, I could have like done circles. I would have been so fast, he couldn't have kept up with me. And I think that I could have got the win. But because I was surrounded by, I think I was getting shot at by 4 different vehicles, I think I was just screwed. So that one's currently left in that match until that match ends, but we're gonna be able to grab something else. Do you guys wanna, should we try out the Patton 48? Or should we go back to our T-54? 48.6, 0.05, 0.17, targeting. So this one has better cannon depression, so it can aim down more, which is kind of nice. Damage, 1,105 hit points versus 930, 216 versus 185. Let's check out the Patton 48 just for fun, just to try something different. This will probably be the last match of the game. Let's see how we can do. Hopefully a little bit better. See you guys in there. So it looks like this one actually has 3 different types of ammo. We have the 90mm AP, armor piercing capped. High penetration deals moderate damage. Then we have the high explosive, doesn't need to penetrate an enemy target to deal damage. Decreased based on the target's armor thickness at the point of impact. Best against enemies that cannot be penetrated with other ammunition types. And then also, we have the heat. Shaped charge ammunition generally deals more damage than armor-piercing ammunition, but has lower penetration. Several types of armor are designated to render it ineffective. Light vehicles. Alright, so we want to use this against heavy tanks, this against light tanks, and this against AFVs. We'll try to remember that. Try to pick those out as we're fighting against them. I'll see you guys in there. Squad up! Let's go, babies! Alright, so ammo number one we want for heavy armor tanks. Ammo two is for little guys like this guy. Ammo three is for the light tanks. Only problem I'm going to have is kind of differentiating heavy from light, but we'll see. We'll see what happens. Here we go,
driver,
boys.
Affirmative. Gunner, scan for target.
Affirmative.
Loader,
all right, so the enemy base is literally straight driver, ahead. Like, couldn't be any more ahead, so we're... Here we go. Texas Patty Melt, I'm following you. Ooh, a Patty Melt sounds good right now. Oh, bro, I'm sorry. Rip. Right into the rock. But yeah, the, like, elevation changes, it makes it tough, because I want to aim down right now, and I can't, you know what I mean? You can't until you get to the other side of it. So we have a lot of guys going this way. I don't really want to get left behind by the squad. So I think I'm going to go with these guys. Can't think of anything worse than being stranded out like we were the last game and just getting absolutely demolished. Alright, we don't want to go through the water. So we're going to go up with these guys. We're going to stick with our squad. We're going to see... Down to 13 kilometers an hour. This thing, dude, oh. Tanks are just so cool. I've always been fascinated with tanks ever since I was a little kid. They're just a cool vehicle, man. Alright, so yeah, we're up here. Looks like there are a lot of enemies over in that direction. Get up here and take a hard loop. Get some action over here as well. Backing up.
Ricochet.
Ricochet? What? We ricocheted off of him, dude, because the angle we were shooting at. I'm assuming. You can get artillery, which I feel like would be kind of useful. Critical module hit.
Hey! Identify target.
Hostile, tank.
I do really like this. No penetration.
Identify
We're
target.
On our armor piercing rounds, dude.
Hey.
Identify target.
Hostile tank.
We're gonna go somewhere else. I don't like this situation. We're gonna move on elsewhere. Looks like our team, we've got four people down. They've got three people down. Another team has three people down. So we're doing okay. Ooh, looks like Moose 456 is flanking enemies. Oh gosh. I'm sorry, Moose.
No pet.
Why? Oh, wait, probably because it's the front of the tank. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, hurry.
Up.
Do do a little bit of damage there. Come on, hurry! Reload. Critical track damage. We don't want to hit the fronts of tanks.
Hit a target.
No effect.
What the heck? I know that the fronts of tanks have the most armor, so I think that's what's happening here. I think we want to hit people on the side. It's 5-7 right now, boys. It's not looking too hot. I'm going to try to come over here. We have 473 hit points left. About half of our health.
Identify.
Hostile, tank.
Somebody that's pretty weak up there. Boys.
Get the
I think we're done. Last stand. Not the best finish there. I don't know. I feel like the first game we had a couple of really good teammates that were running around and doing their thing, and it kind of opened up the map for us. There, we were just like, there were guys with the height advantage on us, and they're just taking us down. So yeah, I mean, that's part of what goes into it. Like, it's about what your team chooses, what you choose, what type of ammo you're choosing, where you're shooting the enemies, dodging people, staying in cover, flanking. Like, there's so much that goes into it. I don't know. I think this is a lot of fun. I think I'm going to play some more of this. If you guys want to see more gameplay from this game, please let me know down in the comments, and also leave thumbs up. If you guys liked it, we might be able to play some more. I know I'm going to play some on my own. I don't know if you guys want to see more, but yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys want to play this game yourself, then go ahead and check out the link down in the description. Like I said, it's a free-to-play game. You don't have to pay anything. You can buy, like, golden stuff to get, like, not better tanks, but, like, you kind of get a rank up faster and you get more credits and stuff like that. So there's kind of an advantage, a slight, like, ranking up advantage for paying. But it's not like you can pay to get better stuff. It's not pay to win by any means. It's completely free to play. You have just as good of stuff not paying as you do by paying, which is kind of cool. So, yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you guys later. Peace out.